Hello and welcome back to Game Domain. Today we're going to be discussing a topic that is relatively up in the air in the Nintendo gaming community, and it revolves around the state of the iconic Super Smash Bros. Series. Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, released for the Nintendo Switch back in 2018, was one of the most hyped up releases in the history of Nintendo, and it can be argued that it was in fact the most. Ultimate is still worshipped by the diehard fanbase till this day, nearly 2 years after its release. This can be attributed to Nintendo's commitment to repeatedly announcing new DLC fighters as part of multiple DLC fighter passes. So far, there are two released DLC passes for purchase, totaling around $55 if you buy both packs. This gives you a total of 10 DLC fighters, 7 of which have been announced and released at the time of this video being written. The first DLC pack consists of Joker, Hero, Banjo and Kazooie, Terry, and Byleth. So far, only two fighters have been announced as part of the second pass, Min Min and Minecraft Steve. The announcement of Steve caused a massive hype uproar in the Super Smash Bros. Fandom, and it seems to be having both positive and negative effects. The positive effect coming out of this is that it's reinvigorating a lot of fans' appreciation and love for Ultimate, and giving them the need to get back into the game and purchase the second DLC fighter pack to be able to play as Steve. The negative effect is, well, people just aren't a fan of having a Minecraft character crossed over into Super Smash Bros. The new hype surrounding this announcement a few weeks back really got us thinking. Does it even make sense for Nintendo to make another Super Smash Bros. Game during the Switch's lifetime? Well, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate was meant to be, of course, the ultimate title in the franchise, bringing back nearly every single past stage and every single past fighter in the history of the series, along with a slew of new fighters that are still being added nearly 2 years post-launch. In the modern gaming world of online Wi-Fi connectivity at the ready, increased game engines and game design and much more powerful consoles all helped to pave the way for DLCs being a staple in nearly any game that they could be included in. Nintendo rarely toyed with DLCs before Smash 4 back on the Wii U, but the Nintendo Switch era seems to have really brought out a whole new Nintendo medium in the form of consistent DLC releases for some of the company's most premier franchises. This deep entrenchment in the world of DLCs leads us to believe that the future of Super Smash Bros. Might just remain in the hands of Ultimate. That is until we get the next generation Nintendo console in however many years. But this is likely at least 3 to 5 years away before we get another Nintendo console, so Nintendo just might keep on doing these DLC passes. Ultimate's lifespan could last for around 2, maybe even 3 more DLC fighter passes before a new game could be in the works. Now, if this is the most plausible option, is this going to be well received and welcomed in the Super Smash Bros. Fanbase? To be honest, what more could we want or expect in a new Super Smash Bros. Game right now? Ultimate is the peak appearance of the series. Not the best game because Melee is still far superior, and it's hard to imagine fans wanting a new game with enhanced graphics because it won't look much better than Ultimate does. Maybe an improved fighting style in the next Smash title? Well, Ultimate also does a pretty good job at this. The only improvement that could be made would be Nintendo literally just importing the incredibly fast-paced and skillful fighting style of Melee into a new Smash game. Ultimate also has a massive soundtrack, with literally an entire music player in there that essentially serves as Spotify for Nintendo Music Remakes. I mean, really, what else could we ask for? The only improvements that could be made are the continued addition of new fighters, new stages, and new music, all of which enhance the gameplay experience. Nintendo can, of course, add new additions of each of these qualities through the DLC packs, so there's really no reason for them to jump to make a new game anytime soon. Super Smash Bros. Fans, and Nintendo fans in general, are always hungry for more Super Smash Bros. Content that will enhance their play experience, and right now, it seems like all of that new content is going to keep on coming in the form of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and the DLC packs that will keep rolling out. So load up your Switch, pop in Ultimate, and get back to fighting. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Tell us what you thought of today's video down in the comments section below. Don't forget to click subscribe and leave a like on today's video, as well as check out some of our other recent uploads. Make sure you also check out the links in the description, as there you'll find the link to our Patreon and to join our Discord. Join our Discord to connect with our staff here at the channel, as well as participate in the great Domain Legion content we have going on there. Our Discord is open to all gaming fans, as we now have over 660 fans of the channel and gamers talking about what we love to do every single day. So come on and join to participate in this great community. We would once again like to thank you guys for all of your incredible support, and thanks for watching today's video. We'll see you next time.